وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى I want to بإذن الله الكريم discuss and cover the strong bond between fasting the month of Ramadan and bravery and courage. Ramadan is a month where the person shows courage and bravery. It's not a month of weakness and da'af. Because you're not eating or drinking, you become weak. Rather, if you look at the Islamic history, you realize that it was in this month that great battles in Islam took place. Let me go through some of them, inshallah ta'ala. The first of them is when the first year of the Islamic Hijriya in the month of Ramadan, and this is of course before Ramadan was made obligatory, meaning fasting was made obligatory. There was an expedition named Saiful Bahri. And this was under the leadership of Hamza ibn Abdul Muttalib, the Prophet's uncle, and his brother also from breastfeeding. They left with 30 men, and this was the first time a number or a group of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ went out to fight, and they went out to defend themselves, regain their rights and what was taken from them. But nothing happened. No fight happened. And the army never met. And no one fought one another. If you go to the Islamic history and you look at it, you see when it was the second year of the Hijriya, in the month of Ramadan, al-Sabi'ashar, the 17th, the greatest battle in Islam, Ma'araka Fasila. This was a fight that distinguished falsehood from truth. قَلَبَتِ الْمَوَازِينَ. This battle changed the scales. This battle is none other than غَزْوَةُ بَدْرٍ الْكُبْرَى. The Battle of Badr. It is ma'araka, a fight that took place that really showed the true essence and the true meaning of bravery and courage. And the battle came to an end with victory on the side of the believers and the Muslims. And this was the first actual time that Muslims and non-Muslims fought one another. And the believers were little in number, but they were strong and powerful in their belief and faith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions it in the Qur'an, لَقَدَ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّةٍ. Allah gave you victory in the Battle of Badr when you were little in number. The Sahabas were very little. And this ma'araka, this jihad happened in the month of Ramadan. It happened on the 17th of Ramadan, in the second year of the Hijriya. The third battle happened when the year was الثالث والعشرين من رمضان, the 23rd of Ramadan, في السنة الثامنة من الهجرة, on the 8th year of the Hijriya. And this is فتح مكة, the conquest of Mecca, بقيادة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was the person who was leading the conquest of Mecca. And this was min a'zam al-intisarat. This was one of the greatest victories that Islam and Muslims saw. The other battle that happened in the month of Ramadan is في الثامن والعشرين من رمضان, on the 28th of Ramadan when the year was 92 Hijrah. Andalus was opened under the leadership and the general Al-Qa'id Al-Bari' Al-Muqatil Al-Fadh Tariq ibn Ziyad rahimahullah. Tariq ibn Ziyad, he had brought victory to the Muslims and Andalus was opened. Also in Ramadan, when the year was 583, the Ma'arakatu Hittin took place under the qiyada of Salahuddin al-Ayyubi. Baytul Maqdis was taken from the Crusades. And this happened in the month of Ramadan when the year was 583. In the month of Ramadan, the year 658, a battle known as Ainu Jalu took place. This is the month of Ramadan again. Believers are fasting. بِقِيَادَةِ سَيْفُ الدِّين قُطْرُس. And this was against the غَزْوَةِ الْمَغُولِي, the Mongolian fight. And it happened in a place called Ainu Jalut, which was close to a place called An-Nasira in Palestine. This became one of the famous battles that took place in Islamic history. Also the year 857, Futihat al-Qustantiniyya, Constantinople was opened ala yad al-Qa'id Muhammad al-Fatih. Muhammad al-Fatih opened Constantinople. When the year was 1213 Hijriyah, in the month of Ramadan, al-Sadis Ashar, on the 16th of Ramadan, the famous battle took place, known as the siege of Napoleon in Hidar al-Nabiliyun, and how he was destroyed against the great walls of Akka, known in English as Akkar, or whatever they call it. And he left with loss. And as he was looking at the walls, he said, تَحَطَّمَتْ أَحْلَامِي عَلَىٰ أَسْوَارِكَ يَا عَكَىٰ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ سَلَامًا لَا لِقَاءَ بَعْدَهِ. He said, my dreams have become destroyed and it has been annihilated. On your walls and your fortresses, O Akka, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ, peace be upon you, سَلَامًا لَا لِقَاءَ بَعْدَهِ, a greeting that there is no greeting after it. And if we went in, I'm not hesitating, but I could show you more than 100 battles that took place in the month of Ramadan, all of it signifying that they saw it as a month of barakah and khair, and it didn't stop them from fighting and fasting. And يَكْفِي الْقِلَادَةَ مَا أَحَاطَ بِالْعُنُقِ. I mean, that is enough for you to understand that this month is a month of working hard. It's not a month of sleeping around and sleeping the whole entire day and staying awake the whole entire night. It's a month of strength and power. It's a month of lifting yourself and your weight and doing what is upon you. If I said anything wrong or incorrect, it's from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.